Hello, everyone. How many of you guys have been waiting for Samurai Champloo episode 2? I know I am. Oh, so Mugen, remember last episode, I somehow recognized the voice actor, which after I was done watching, I searched it is actually the voice actor of Zoro, Kazuya Nakai. That's pretty cool. I recognized his voice so quickly. But anyways, on to the recap. Mugen and Jin met for the first time in the midst of running away from the governor and his minions. They got caught. They were about to be executed, but were saved by Fu, hostess of one of the tea house around that area. They agreed into the condition of finding this samurai that smells like sunflower. But alright, let's get started. No need to hold it off. Okay, episode 2. Samurai Champloo. All right, ready? 3, 2, 1, go. It's very opposite. You can tell Mugen is very out there, very aggressive type fighting skills, and then Jin is the very opposite. Restrained, calm, collected, but both are very strong. Holy shit. Yeah. Oh no. God damn it. Whoa, that's pretty cool. Wow. Maybe he's hiding something? What? Oh. So did I? Okay, I'm not gonna. What? I didn't expect that. People to do what? I feel like this is a trap. Who are they targeting? Mugen? Jin? Fu? Who? Okay, so he's the one. I thought this is a different town. Okay. So they're the target. Holy shit. Oh. Oh, he's manipulating him. Yeah, he has his own story. That's why I didn't connect. He just. Oh, wow. Holy shit. He's manipulating him. Oh, God. So he's the ogre. Yeah, that guy was from the first episode. Okay, gotcha. Yeah, what happened? That's really sad. Jesus Christ, Mugen. My gosh. I knew it! Oh no. He's part of it too. God damn it. Yeah. Nothing personal. Why are you carrying that? Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Oh, the ogre. That was my first impression earlier. But yeah, he looks like the guy from the tea house who burns the tea house. Wow. I knew he's not just something weak samurai. He's hiding it. Ooh. Oh, gosh. So confident. Oh gosh, he did want to end it. Wow. Yeah, he became friends with, yeah, he became friends with her, so only friends. So you cannot. Yeah, holy. Ah. No. Okay. Well, I don't know what. Oh no. Yeah, you don't have to. You don't have to finish it. What's gonna happen if he continues? How strong is this guy? Yeah, I would. I'm not gonna be surprised. Yeah. I'm not gonna be surprised if I'm gonna meet you again or they're gonna meet you again. Wow. Interesting. Wow. Yeah. Because you're my only friend. He just explained to you he was alone. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Yeah. Oh. Oh. Well. Well, that's pretty good. Yeah, I didn't realize at first. I was like, wait, does that really look like him? The guy who burned the tea house? But okay. Oh, so it is kind of like the, I don't know, per episode they kind of like continuing from what happened, like just a connection linking into it. But I feel bad for the guy. He didn't mention his name, but you know, the ogre. I guess we could just describe him that for now. But yeah, he's just a sad fellow. Didn't have any chance to, you know, live in a normal, accepted kind of life. But yeah, Mugen is lucky. That transpires of Fu befriending him and then. Because otherwise, what would happen? Mugen could have died, either from fighting or poison. Well, yeah. Well, but holy shit! He just choked. He just break the guy's spinal cord. That, whatever his name is. But wow, and Jin, yeah, and that assassin. I really believe that they're gonna meet up again. It's pretty strong. But, all right, that's really good. And like I always say, this series, I'm liking it so far. But I hope you're enjoying it. I really like it. There's a little bit of an adult scene. I realize it now. But yeah, just gonna end it now, guys, for now. And see you in the next upload. Bye.